In this video, we'll give you a brief introduction to ISF shaders, browsing different categories of shaders with ISF Loader, using these different kinds of shaders, how we can edit shader files, and where we can find more shaders. In short, shaders are pieces of code that instruct the GPU how to generate or manipulate visuals. On the About page of the website editor.isf.video, we can find the following description. ISF stands for Interactive Shader Format and is a file format that describes a GLSL fragment shader as well as how to execute and interact with it. So rather than it just being a set of instructions that can be executed, there are parameters that we can interact with in real time. On the same website, we can browse for freely downloadable shader files. Before we decide to download any, we can also interact with the shader's parameters right here in the browser. These are the same parameters we will be able to control in live using ISF Loader. We'll download this shader for now, but we'll get back to using it later in this video. ISF Loader comes with a curated library of over 200 shaders, some of them from the website we've just discussed. The shader files can be found in the factory folder, which is installed into the video sync folder inside the user library. We have direct access to this folder in ISF Loader thanks to its browser, which we can hide when we no longer need it. There is also a user folder so that we can add our own shaders and have easy access to them. Again, more on this later. There are three categories we can use to filter these shaders. Generators, which generate visuals and usually ignore the input, as ISF Loader is technically an effect device. Filters, which in live's context we would call effects, as they manipulate visuals that are fed into the device. And transitions, which we can use to create transitions between two different tracks. We'll explore these more later on in this video. Let's start off with browsing for a generator shader. As soon as we select one, we can find some information about it in the information panel in the center, which can also be hidden. On the right end of the device are the parameter controls. Every shader has a different amount of parameters, so the interface automatically shows the appropriate amount of parameter controls with a maximum of 16. These dials can be automated and modulated. To get an overview of all the parameters that a shader comes with, we can open the configure window. Here, all parameters are listed from top to bottom. On the right side, we can see whether a shader parameter has been mapped to one of the 16 parameter controls. The first 16 parameters of a shader are always mapped automatically to the parameter controls in the device, but in case we want to change our mappings or start from scratch, we can use the Unmap All button at the top. We can also remove or add parameter controls from view or hide them altogether. Now let's add another ISF loader. And use a filter shader this time. We can keep adding other video sync effects as well, or even more ISF loaders with filter shaders. Instead, let's use a transition shader this time. For this, we are going to need a new track. Let's trigger this video so that we have some content for track 1, so that we can create a transition between these two tracks. Out of the box, we can use Live's own crossfader to create simple crossfade transitions. But with ISF Loader, we get a lot more options. As soon as we select a transition shader, we are informed that this shader currently has unused image inputs. Image inputs can be compared to sidechain inputs in the audio domain. When we open the configure window, we can see two flashing drop-down menus from which we can select our two input tracks. Once both are selected, the message automatically disappears, and we can use the progress parameter to control the transition. We will have to either mute or set the source tracks to sends only, as the combined output of both tracks is now coming from track 3. If we're not satisfied with the transition shader we've chosen, we can keep browsing for other transition shaders, as both selected tracks will be retained as long as the category is set to transitions. In case we want to do something with the file of the currently selected shader, we can open the enclosing folder with this button in the information panel. while we're here in the Finder, let's unzip the shader file we downloaded earlier and move its content into the user folder. If we then right-click one of the shader files with the .fs extension inside the factory or user folders and hit Get Info, we can set the default application with which we'll want to open shader files. Any text editor will do, but in this case we're going for Visual Studio Code. The Edit File button, once clicked, will then open whichever shader we have selected in our text editor. After adding some changes to our code and saving our file, the changes will be immediately reflected in Live and VideoSync. Furthermore, in case there is something wrong with our code, error messages will be displayed in the information panel. In case you'll want to look for more shaders, editor.isf.video is a great place to start. ShaderToy.com is another option, although shaders from this website will need to be converted first. We have a blog article that will take you through the few steps to convert ShaderToy shaders for use with ISF Loader. There is a link in the description below.